A photo becomes particularly powerful when it has showed something that was about to happen. We are constantly reminded that we are unable to connect dots looking forward, so it becomes almost essential for one to make meaning out of historic events looking backwards. While photos are just like fragments of memories, they allow us to see how time could be non-linear by piecing together the memories of others. Here, as it seems, time no longer exists. The anterior future becomes our present. Before my grandfather passed away, he left behind over 10,000 old images taken throughout his life. With the help of hindsight, I see many of the photos were snapped right before the subject's life changed dramatically. There is no imminent danger visible in these portraits. However, we know what happened. Should we just let it fade into the history? Or maybe we can connect the dots and see what we can find out. Born in early 1940s, when my grandfather was like 20 years old, he went to Beijing for the Great Cultural Revolution. What's real interesting about these images is that the subjects couldn't have any idea where the history would go toward and what their position would be in the future. By the time my grandfather stood at Tiananmen Square, he still had 1 year left for his medical bachelor degree to finish. So when he finished college, he was already around 25 years old. It became very hard for us to believe that such an intellectual man had been through the Great Cultural Revolution and still successfully became a surgeon afterwards. He slowly made himself a well-established surgeon in China, thanks to his great skill. In 1987, he went with the Chinese delegation for medicine, visiting Europe for research. However, none of this could have been told when he was inside the stone of Great Cultural Revolution, when he was standing at Tiananmen Square. When he didn't even meet my grandmother. He couldn't predict his future, but with all these passes combined, with all these dots connected, we can see a pattern coming out from the surface. And maybe this anterior future has always been set, while we just don't know. From all these images, we would never have any idea how my mother was abused by her own family, how she didn't even have a chance to fight back. Of course, as a famous surgeon, my grandfather never wanted his daughter to be unfairly and viciously treated by her mother. Nonetheless, he still didn't even predict that he would just be the bystander and not stopping his wife from abusing his own daughter. It is very surprising for me to acknowledge that my grandfather was living in such a patriarchal family and that they only actually took great care of my uncle, who is the younger brother of my mother. While for my mother, all these traumatic experiences still remain having a negative impact on her life until today, long past my grandfather's death. Their love for each other was so complex and hard to explain due to these reasons, and I believe only through connecting these dots, revealing all these patterns, can we have a chance to prevent similar events from happening in our own anterior future. If even the most prestigious, well-established surgeon can have an imperfect family, maybe we should reconsider ourselves. Maybe we should no longer take all this just for granted. And maybe we should not judge so quickly. Just like it can be very hard to see through the fog in the midst of history, merely seeing the appearance of a family album should not be enough for us to see the full picture. Our family albums and all these archives, as a matter of fact, serve as modern-day social media platforms for all different kinds of people to record their happy memories. Maybe we are never so happy, and it's never the fault of social media. You see, even when we only shot films and printed photos through specialty shops, we kept only the most delightful ones in them. It is pretty similar to us keeping only the biggest smile in our Facebook album. Maybe it's just human. We are far too afraid to see through the reality. We want to be happy, of course, but only honestly, no one could be happy all the time. So either the family album or the social media all serve the same purpose, which is to record our happy memories, to prevent ourselves from being too overwhelmed by the myriad of truths in real life. It seems to me a universal problem that should be resolved, but has never been for decades. Way before when social media became a thing.